quickly compared to a lot of dogs that might take more than a few training sessions to understand the concept. However, Maggie, showing off her superstardom, got it at the end of the video. So we're going to work on that again today, kind of refresh her memory in regards to the choosing which emblem, and also we're going to possibly incorporate another one here. So let's get this all set up here. And I have her treats broken up into very, very small pieces. We want to make sure that we give her very tiny pieces because we will be rewarding her frequently. We don't want an upset tummy or anything like that. Stop. Sit. Good. Okay, so here we go. We're going to go with Army first. Now I'm choosing Army because it's an easy word, and that was the first one that she learned this last time here. So I have this on a towel. I did have other ones on a mat previously, but we'll do it on the towel today just because of the contrast in colors. I guess that would be values for Maggie. Dogs can see some color. Okay. Okay. So, she's jumping the gun. She knows what's going on. She knows this game. Wait. We want to make sure that she does not do anything until we give her the command to do so. So, if you see her trying to paw at one, this one or this one without giving a command, you can just ignore that and have her focus back on you and work on it from there. All right, so we don't want Maggie to think too much. I know when food is involved, she really just tries to pull out all the stops to get her treats. So we want her to kind of slow it down. We want her to think about what's going on. Yes. Good Army. Good Army. See, we're reinforcing the command. Good Army. Ah. Okay, we'll do it again. Wait. Army. Yes. Good Army. All right, she totally licked her chops after she touched that, so she's extremely motivated by food today. Army, yes. Good Army, good girl. Okay, so now she knows the Army. We did this before, she's remembering. Let's switch it up and go back to the Air Force one that we went over in a previous video. Wait. Air Force. So she's really trying to hurry up with this. I want her to slow down, calm down. We're going to make sure that we think about things before we go ahead and just put our paws on whatever. So, Nanny, Army. Yes! Good Army! Good girl! Good Army! Wait. Army. Yes! Good Army! Good Army! Okay, so last time when we did this, and we had Army on one side, and she was doing a great job identifying the Army, touching it with her paw. We do say Air Force. She might get a little confused. So in the very beginning, I want to make sure that I can point to the Air Force, and we'll go from there. Air Force. Nope. Nope. Air Force. Yes! Good, Air Force. Sit, sit. Good girl. Air Force. Good, Air Force. Wait. Wait. Maggie, Air Force. Yes! Yes. Good Air Force. Good Air Force. Wait. Maggie. Maggie. Hey, focus. Army. Ah! All right, jump in the gun there. Wait. Army. Yes. Good girl. About it too much, or maybe she gets a little bit desperate to make a decision, hurry up so I can get some treats. She picks whichever one may be closer to her, whichever one may stand out. However, asking her to wait gives her time to calm down a little bit, and then when you know that she's focused on you, she's making eye contact. When you address her, she her ears perk up, she makes eye contact, then at that point we would know that that's the perfect time to ask her to identify Army or Air Force. Army! Army! Yes! Good Army! Good Army! Air Force. Nope. Yes. Okay, having a little bit of trouble with the Air Force right now. That's okay. I will wait to introduce the Coast Guard. I want to make sure that we can identify both of these a little bit easier. And I don't want to introduce anything that's going to make it more difficult. We want to manage this right now. She's doing a good job, though. Air Force, focus, focus. Staring at a bug in here right now. Yes. Good. Air Force, Air Force, Air Force, yes. Good, Air Force, good girl. Wait. Army. No.